When we look at a horse's back, I always encourage people, lunge a horse's back on a halter and take your phone and put it on slow motion. You will see the walk is this way, trot is this way, and canter is this way. Okay, so there is one pivot point what moves a lot. So no rodeo rider sits in the middle of the horse's back. So where do they sit? Let me see if I have a picture. Here you see a rider. The horse is nicely stretched, not behind the vertical, right? Very close to the horse's withers. So if the rider would sit where my arrow is here in the middle, that's the spot where it moves a lot. Okay, so that's a lot of movement. The reason saddles slide forward is if your saddle is too long. Okay, so 90% of all saddles, I hate to say it, but unfortunately, many, many, many saddles are too long. So here is a picture. I'm gonna enlarge it a little bit so you can see it better. So here's a picture of the saddle support area with lots of little marks on top. And these marks are reflex points but cause negative reaction. So if your saddle sits in this area right here, okay, and does not extend that pink bar, which is, happens to be where the last rib is, then you're away from where the back wants to kick the saddle forward. So all these points can create a lot of problem to the horse and the rider, because this back one here, if your saddle does hit that one, the nickname of that one is the bucking reflex points. This one here is the lung meridian point. In other words, if your saddle slides too far forward, it will hit BL13, that's a bladder meridian point 13, and that horse will get an elevated heart rate, which means increased cortisol level, which means the horse will have stress. So that is a problem if the saddle slides forward. It has to stay back. So the question is perfect. Why does it go forward? Number one is the saddle is too long. Number two, in the old days, when the soldier learned from his officer how to select the right saddle for the horse, the second he learned is how to correctly place the cinch. Okay, so more and more saddles now are designed so the rider has the possibility or the ability to put the billets in the right spot. Number two is the billets have to hang perpendicular in the right spot. So if I'm see if I have a picture here, probably not on this slideshow, but it's really, really important that the saddle does not go forward, right? So no, not on this slideshow. Maybe I very clear. Let's come back to that maybe next week, that I prepare a different slideshow for that. And the last not least, very often, I'm sorry to say that, but it is actually us, the rider. So if you sit in a non-gender appropriate saddle and you are not sitting in the plumb line to your sitting motion, you are actually forcing that saddle forward. So if it's not the rider, then look at the billets. Here in this particular saddle, you see how the billets are in the forward position. Many, many saddles have the billets coming out of the center, and some of the new modern one even from the rear, okay? As you see on this horse here, the deepest point is in the center, and the girth will always go to the smallest area. So if your billets don't hang in the right spot, it pulls your saddle forward. The third reason why your saddle goes forward is because the tree width, it's not the right tree width. It's most of the time too narrow. Many people misunderstand the angle, that's the angle of the tree, with the tree width. So how would it look on the tree? It would be like this. I take this one. Okay, you see two corners here. Okay, these two corners, if I spread it, you can see this particular one is broken, but pretend it would be a tree where you can adjust the tree this way. And okay, we develop right now one where you can actually do that, right? You can see it easy, where that goes wide. That's a tree width. And then the bottom here, many non-trained saddle fitters, self-claimed saddle fitters, or fitters who got a paper somewhere and then go out and get a hydraulic machine, they spread your tree, but most of the time, if you have a wood tree, they break the tree point. You wouldn't see it fall off because there is steel underneath. Like in this one, you see the steel underneath there, okay, and the steel on top. So they break the tree point, bending the steel. But back to what I was saying, this is the tree width, and then this is the angle. Okay, so let's summarize that. The length of the saddle, then the billet's positioning here, right? You gotta hang perpendicular. If the rider sits shoulder, hips, and heels correctly, they will not push with their seat the saddle forward. Tree width and angle. These are the most common one. Sometimes you see when you turn the saddle over, the channel is not wide enough. Some saddles are purposely built like this. We call it the close pin fit. When I say we, as a saddle company, I would never do it because it's detrimental to the horse and cause long-term damage to the horse. But some saddles are super narrow in the channel. Here you see a cross-section of a vertebrae, and if the saddle, the panels, the stuffing, if they're not wide enough, they will press on that spine, and they will ride on the spine like a train on the rail, forward. Okay? So here you got the five reasons a saddle will go forward. I hope that answers your question.